So hey, hello everyone, and welcome to my channel. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to implement touch Linux command by using a C program. So before going to the video, kindly subscribe my channel. It's really helpful for me. So let's get started. So currently, I'm going to implement this type this program in C in my Dev C++. You can use any editor because we are just going to copy this code over here, and I'm going to paste it and run it in REPL IT Linux. So REPL IT, using REPL IT, we can just create an online Linux terminal. So it's not necessary to have Linux OS install, we can just do it in online. So let's get started with the header files. So first, just include the header file as include stdio.h. So this is what I'm going to do. We are just going to create a file basically, and we are just going to use the command fopen, because fopen creates a file. So we're just going to pass the file name as a text file or something. That's going to pass as a command line argument and extract the command line and just create a file. So this is going to be a very simple one. So next, the main function, int main, and since it's a command line, int argc, this is the argument count, and the char asterisk, that is the character array, argv. So I think you know this. If you don't know, This is the argument count, that is the number of arguments that we are passing. So it's a form of integer, and this is the string. Okay, the argument that is passing is string basically, but it is taken as a character array. So that's what it is. So next thing, we are going to create a file. So we need a file. Okay, file asterisk and fptr. Okay, fptr of f is basically good, and f equal to open. So that's what we are going to do. So here we don't have any file. Okay, so by default in C, if the file doesn't exist, C automatically creates a file. So that's what is needed in touch basically. We're going to create a file, and if you just pass the file name, C automatically is going to create a file. So fopen is going to be argument of 1. So the reason we are giving argument of 1 is that argument of 0 is going to be our dot slash edit out. So we'll viewing the output, I will explain this clearly when you're running the code in the Linux terminal. So while we are viewing the output, we will compile it, gcc that compile it, and dot slash header out we will be giving, and that required input as a command line. So the dot slash header out command will be also considered as an argument, and that's count is argument of 0, it's a 0th index, and our file name is going to be argument of 1, that's going to be the first index. So this is the reason we are giving argument of 1. So that basically we need two arguments in this program. So we are going to open it in the form of a write mode. Okay, write. So after this piece of code, you can basically just use a if statement to check whether you have entered two arguments, because first argument is going to be dot slash header out and second argument is going to be our file name. So you can give a if statement and check whether there's two argument or not. If the user given two argument, proceed, and else just hit an error. It's basically just optional, and just close it. That's the code. It's so f close and just pass the file variable name f, and it's f open. Actually it's not open, it's f open. So that's the piece of code. If you want here, you just insert a if statement. That's completely your wish. So how it works is that basically you will just give a file name, dot slash to your file name, and the file name is going to be argument vector of 1. So this f is equal to f open. So in C, this is used to open a file. So our file doesn't exist actually. So if the file is in there, C automatically creates a file. So that's it, and creating file and close it, simple process over here. So this is how touch also works. Touch creates a file. So I think that's the code over here. Just copy this piece of code and just go to Google and type REPL IT Linux. So sign it up, and you can just create a Linux terminal online. So it isn't necessary to go on OS, Linux OS, and type. So just type bash, add a new REPL bash, and type name of your folder. I'll type new program, something, create REPL. So it will be creating an online Linux terminal for us. So as you can see here, we have put it. So pw means returns the root from root to our code. So first we need to create a C program. So touch mypro.c. So as you can see, our C program is created, and I will just paste the code over here. So that's good. And I will compile the code, gcc mypro, that's the program name.c. So it hasn't got any errors. Then next is dot slash a dot spread out, and our file name that needs to get created. So new file dot txt, and if I just hit enter, so as you can see here, new file dot txt file is created. So this is what touch command also is, create a new file. So that's it. If you want to also create, you can create a dot c file also, dot slash reload new file, new name, new c dot c. So as you can see, it also created a dot c file. So that's it, basically just three lines of code we can implement touch command. If you can, if you want to add, you can also if statement inside it. So that's it for this video, and I also done many tutorials in other commands in also Linux, also run cat touch is here. Okay, dear. So do check out my other videos, okay? And I also done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Blender, Unity. So more programming stuff, check out my video list of my channel and subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.